numerical readouts are good. I got some snacks. Just kidding. You're good to go. I'm patching everyone into SHIELD's intel.
Thank you. friend?
We're all anxiously awaiting your return. Come home safe.
So it's totally safe to keep the snow here, right? Guys? Right? Guys?
On the enemies. Find yourself in a tactically sound position. You've got more endurance than ever before. New orders are on the way. If the enemy gives you any kind of an opening, you take it.
Okay!
As you wish.
Yeah.
and food.
We're all anxiously awaiting your return. Come home safe. I can help. I'm sure of it.
Ah, good. You're all here. I have some updates on Yuno's condition, among other things. This question may seem rather wild, but have you ever heard of a devouring apocalypse? Excellent. I'll keep it brief. Aragami aimed to swallow everything, even ultimately the entire planet. Thus, the devouring apocalypse. These massive disasters have occurred over and over again since the dawn of time. When the planet is threatened or destabilized, the apocalypse rises to set the balance right again. Essentially, the Earth resets and all life begins anew. Understand so far? The devouring apocalypse has a sort of trick that is essential to its birth, the singularity. One of these appeared in the Far East 3 years ago. Long story short, it ended up on the moon. That explains the moon's greening, if you will. Point being, Earth was safe from the singularity.
I knew of the lost singularity, but I had no idea it was connected to the moon's change of color.
I wouldn't suspect so. Only a few people here at the branch know the whole truth of what happened. All of which brings me to the matter at hand. Are you all still with me? In brief, singularity makes devouring apocalypse. Apocalypse resets Earth. Earth redistributes life. I'll begin with my hypothesis. We believe that the red rain and black plague are Earth compensating for our current imbalance and creating a new singularity. Keep in mind, this entire theory is based on the results of Miss Yuno's examination.
No, Director, you can't be saying that.
What is it?
I'm truly sorry to say it, but I fear Miss Yuno has been chosen as the new singularity. Her infection has advanced much more rapidly than any of the other patients. Upon a more detailed investigation, we discovered a bias factor within her that echoed the singularity's pattern. It appears the Black Plague's bias factor is meant to transform its host into a singularity. The two are directly intertwined. The plague drains life from its host in an attempt to trigger a singularity until they waste away. Perhaps this is the world's will, to create a new singularity and trigger a new apocalypse. Our best chance to stop it is to treat the plague. I'll dedicate all resources toward finding a cure. I'm sure I will require your help. I hope I can count on all of you.
Thank you.
are all showing nominal levels. Let's begin the mission.
Here we go.
I'm patching everyone into Shield intel.
Thank you. for tomorrow.
Goodness, I was really worried about you for a moment.
That was a tough one, but you earned that victory.
Oh, no!
It's time, my sweet. The final test is here. Everything will go just as we've planned, Julius. Everything will be perfect. Poor Julius. Poor beautiful Julius. It seems you truly stand before the Grim Reaper himself.
I won't give in. Not until every last Origami is purged from this world.
Fear not. The God Ark soldiers have almost taken in all your gifts. Stay strong, my angel of battle.
Rachel, you'll finish it soon, before this sickness can take me.
Of course, as I swore to you I would. Julius, I've come to a decision. I think it will grant you a measure of peace. Together, we shall nurture the God Ark soldiers. With them, there shall be no need for God Eaters to risk their lives against the Origami. It may sound almost mad now, but think of it all. No God Eater would ever have to die. We'd never suffer another loss like sweet Romeo. The God Ark soldiers have it now. They have incorporated the plague's bias factor. They've been taught by your courage, trained in your blood power, strengthened by your sickness. Here, in this moment, they are almost as perfect a soldier as you are, my child. No God Eater will ever have to die, Julius. For you will live on forever inside my God Ark soldiers.
So much sacrifice built this metal army. Even after I've gone to hell, this...
No, my Julius. This mission you chose is not meant to end.
Mission? I'm finished here, Rachel. All I have left to do is visit Romeo's grave and bid him a last goodbye. I'll see the others, too, if they'll even meet me.
All of that is meaningless now. You will be sovereign over all mankind. When at last you overcome this final ordeal, you will rise like the sun and burn this world.
What are you talking about? Rachel!
Julius, you're an angel, my sweet, precious Julius. I knew it from the very first moment I laid eyes on you. And when the restless god told me that of all the chosen, it was you who could grant my wish, what began as a suspicion became assurance. Since my true birth, I have been dedicated to this task, to burn away the corrupted old world and raise the light of dawn over a new one. This earth is kindling now. All its people have served, each one a loyal pawn. Well, no, that is untrue. All save you, my valiant knight.
but there is much to do, and little time. Until then, my perfect Julius, sleep well. A rest well earned, my knight.